Motovlog test number 2.
This time
I've got it mounted on my dirt bike helmet, and we're going to take the 310 out for a spin. Got that hooked up. Oh. Can't find my snap. Or is that in the way? Here we go. Alright. That looks a little crooked. If I do that a little bit. But still, it's all the way up. And verify that it is all the way back. This is my open face helmet. Come off of there. See? There's a clamp there, got the strap on there, but that's the clamp, that's what we're looking at right there. Get my goggles on. And there we go. Let's see how this sounds. Riding a 310. Oh, this is so much. This is lightweight. Let's go get some gas. This feels way different. Up here and get some gas. Easy now. Run up here to the gas station. People don't know what to do when they see this motorcycle. And we'll pull up right here. Alright. Look that up when I get back. Never seat, that's filled up. Electric start. Go. Open face helmet, goggles, same setup. Wonder what the Again, running my Kenda K270s. Open face helmet, goggles. Heading on down the road. Now what's funny is I don't know what the microphone's hearing, but with my open face helmet and my goggles, I don't seem to hear as much wind in my head as I did with my shielded adventure helmet on. And here we are, we're doing 40, 45. This bike geared so low. The definitely for woods riding, not for roads riding. Yep, I'm in sixth gear. Yep. Getting up to 52. Turn my head sideways, see what the whirlings look like. Turn my head sideways and I don't hear as much wind in my helmet, but I wonder what the microphone's hearing. But anyway, getting out here today, checking all this out. We're just gonna do the short loop, because we know with this open face helmet, traveling at road speed, it's gonna be pretty freaking loud. But again, this is a stock setup. Gonna make a turn here. Could probably use a super wide on this. If I'm standing up, ride, what's it gonna be like looking down the road, down the trail, sitting back down, aggressive ride, could be, this will all, we'll figure all this out on the trail on our first day. I'll take the I've got an extension for the mount, so I could get the bottom a little bit further out, which would allow me to turn the camera angled up just a little more. But it may need it, it may not. Man, and I hear people talk about balancing their tires. I have never balanced, like right now, I've got these dual sport tires on here. I don't feel it bouncing. Guess maybe I'm just lucky that way. Got a donkey up there, a goat. See, that's all I gotta do is go down one turn from my house and I'm kinda back in the country, other than more expensive neighborhoods that came in. But man, when we first moved out here, it was right up above our neighborhood. Our neighborhood was the only thing out here. And I don't know, there's 100-something houses in there built back in the mid-70s. And farmland all around our neighborhood. Come home from work one day and see two deer playing up in the field right above our house two or three times. Cows got out of their fence and were, two times there was freaking cows in my front yard. That was awesome. But they got out of their fence and came walking through the neighborhood. All right, let's go down here. Get it slowed down a little bit in a neighborhood, see what it sounds like here, because this is what it would be like on my dual sport ride. That's 26 miles an hour, man. In the woods, 26 miles an hour, you're doing good. What have they got done up here? Anything? Get off on the dirt here a little bit, see what's happening. So just kind of get that ride. So standing up, doing my ride, sitting down. Getting up on the seat, making this turn. So really not gonna be riding head down. Boy, and I can feel it. I got these tires pumped up for the road. I can feel it on this bumpy dirt. But yeah, going down through here, that'd be good. That's a good little test there. What else have we got down here? Don't want to wear out my welcome. Don't want anybody calling the police. Want to get out of here before. Here we go. See what that sounds like. See how much wind's picked up there. Because I will do that in the pines, I'm sure. Slow down. What we got out here? What we got out here? What do we got out here? Let's adventure down this thing, see where this goes. Yeah, I gotta remember I don't have my knobbies on here, so I can't ride quite as aggressive as I normally do when I have knobbies on. Not that I ride killer aggressive. Alright, let's head back to the house. I think that was a good enough test to see if this angle is gonna work. See how much noise I get, see if you can hear me talking. Maybe I'll post this, maybe I won't. I don't know. It's just actually a little test. But should I decide to post it, this would go along with my GoPro mount, microphone mount for the Motovlogs, which will probably get done and posted after I post this one. I just did the KLR Delusional this morning. And yeah, I'll probably post this just to post something up. Again, celebrating 300 subscribers. I do appreciate that. Never expected to get over 10, 15. But hey, it's pretty cool. Gives me some more enthusiasm about doing the vlogs. I mean, shoot, it was 7-8 months ago when I posted my last one, and since then my subscriber count grew a little bit. Surprising for not posting, and my subscriber count grew. I think a lot of them are because of the e-bike stuff, which I haven't been riding that. Heck, I haven't been riding anything much. Been working all the time, and on the nice weekends it's been too wet because it's been raining here in the Carolinas like crazy, and I've become a fair weather rider for the fact of I don't have the time to clean the bike, but I am enjoying this Sunday. Beautiful weather. Don't have anything really to do but bike stuff, which is awesome. I may even do a e-bike vlog, see how this mount works on my helmet. So I've done absolutely nothing from my KLR vlog as far as the whole camera and microphone setup. I took it right off of the adventure helmet, stuck it on my Fox Moto helmet, and now we're out on the 310. Like I said, man, this is geared pretty low. It is geared for the woods, not the road. So really the top speed I care to do on this is 55 miles an hour, which is what we'll be doing on some of the road parts of our annual Armenia dual sport ride. This will be, man, I can't remember which one this will be, 14th maybe, and I only missed the very first one. Done it every year since. All the proceeds, man, Marvin Grant is an awesome guy. He's the one that organizes this whole thing. He's got a whole crew of people that does the layout, and it's like an enduro with some paved sections, but it's like an enduro, man. It's not some, you don't want to take a KLR 650 on it, I'll put it that way. It's definitely some tight wood ride. And all the proceeds go to the Armenia Methodist Church. And man, over the 12, 13 years that I've been doing this, I think it was last year that Marvin had a whole picture display of everything that our donations have paid for at the church, and it's just freaking awesome. Just does the heart good to know that, hey man, dirt bikers did that. And if you're interested, today again is Sunday the 28th, April 28th. You can look it up, you can just Google it and you'll find it. It's Armenia Dual Sport. It's in Chester, South Carolina. And it's limited to 150 riders, but I have never known Marvin to turn away any riders that show up the day of the event. I always pre-register. As soon as I get the notice, I send my check-in. And what we do for our vacation, moto vacation, me and Jeff and Mike Danford, can't believe I said that. Me and James Shaver, Mike Danford, and Kevin Hanks, and also in memory of our good buddy Jeff McDonald, we head down to Ennery, South Carolina, to that ORB park Wednesday, Thursday of that week. We camp out there, ride for a couple days, do some night riding out there, load up Saturday afternoon, well, sometimes Saturday morning, so we can go get a good spot. Head over to Marvin's over outside of Chester, set up camp there, go ahead and get registered, watch the first motocross race of the season. He's always got that on TV. Yeah, it's just a tradition, man. It's a good time. Good food. Man, just check into it. You might even see some, you can also find some YouTube videos on it. I posted one years ago, and there's been other guys that have stayed on top of it that have posted some, so it's all worth checking out. But anyway, there was our ride on the 310, and it's definitely ready. Just gotta swap out my tires, do an oil change, and I don't know if you saw that here. This is a 13. This is 2019, and I only got 1700 miles on this thing. It's embarrassing, but anyway, that's it, buddies. And check it out, and I'll probably post this thing, and then I'll do a post on this whole video vlogging setup that I'm using, if it all worked out. Later.